Hello everyone. In this lecture, I'll be discussing about the psychrometric chart and its use. So before going through this lecture, I have already made two lectures on the concept of humidification and its basic terminology. So if you go through those videos, you'll be understanding the concept and the terminologies which we'll be using in this psychrometric chart. Now coming to this video, the psychrometric chart is used for understanding relation between various parameters like dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, dew point temperature, absolute humidity, percentage humidity, humid volume and enthalpy. So if you know any two quantities of these seven, the other five can be found from this chart. So in a simple term, if you know any of the two quantities, then all the other parameters can be found using the psychrometric chart. This is how a psychrometric chart looks roughly. I have taken so that it will be easy for understanding, where my y-axis will be with absolute humidity, humid volume and enthalpy, and my x-axis will be of temperature. Now suppose if I know the absolute humidity and dry bulb temperature, that is two quantities y dash and t dry bulb temperature quantities I know. Now the other five quantities I need to find. So how to proceed the psychrometric chart I will be explaining in detail here. So proceeding now, this is my absolute humidity y dash, and let it be my dry bulb temperature at this point. So there are different curves like these, ranging from 0 to 100, the percentage humidity 0, 10%, 20%, 30% in this graph. So wherever the point of intersection of TD and YD in this graph, this point of intersection on this curve will give my percentage humidity. That means you got one quantity, that is percentage humidity. And these are called the adiabatic saturation curve lines, ranging in this manner. So as you got the point of intersection of TD and Y dash in this graph, simply follow this adiabatic saturation curve till the 100% humidity, that is completely saturated. So as I explained you, at complete saturation you will get that point, that will be my adiabatic saturation temperature. And for air water system, I have derived that adiabatic saturation temperature and wet bulb temperature will be equal. So in this way, if you take it in the x-axis, you will get the wet bulb temperature or adiabatic saturation temperature. So you got the second term. And as I told you, the dew point temperature, if you reduce the temperature, what will happen? My vapor pressure will reduce, and decrease in vapor pressure will increase my relative humidity. So I will decrease in this way towards the left side, then my relative humidity or percentage humidity will decrease, where at certain point it will reach 100% humidity. That point the condensation will start, because the air can no longer hold the water molecules, and my condensation will start. At that temperature I will get my dew point temperature. It is simply that y dash you just extrapolate to 100% humidity point, and you will get the dew point temperature. Now I got the three quantities: percentage humidity, wet bulb temperature and dew point. Now coming to the enthalpy. Now it is very simple. Now you know the dry bulb temperature here, and in the graph you will see two enthalpy terms, that is enthalpy of saturated air and enthalpy of dry air. Which means that for dry air the absolute humidity will be 0, and for saturated air you will have certain saturated absolute humidity. So just extrapolating this dry bulb temperature on these two points, one is the saturated air enthalpy and the dry air enthalpy, you will get two points, and extrapolating with these two points, you will get the enthalpy. Similarly, the humid volume will also be given in terms of humid volume, specific volume of dry air and the specific volume at saturated air. So these are the two curves, and at the dry bulb temperature you will get the two points, saturated air humid volume, and the other is dry air humid volume. And by interpolating these two points, you will be getting the humid volume. I will explain you with an example so that you can understand it easily. So this is how you need to use psychrometric chart to get the various parameters if any of the two quantities are known. Suppose if I know the wet bulb temperature and dry bulb temperature, then what I will do? First, I will extrapolate this wet bulb temperature on this 100% humidity curve. Then I will follow this adiabatic saturation curve, where my dry bulb temperature will meet this adiabatic saturation curve. That point in the y-axis will be my absolute humidity, and from the absolute humidity, if I draw it towards the 100% humidity curve, I will get the dew point temperature and I will get the percentage humidity. Similarly, I will get the humid volume and enthalpy. So if you know any of the two quantities, you can find the other five quantities from the psychrometric chart. So let me take you to an example. So this is the example where determine the following properties of moist air having a dry bulb temperature of 50 degrees and wet bulb temperature of 34 degrees centigrade, and the psychrometric chart at this pressure, 1 atmosphere, you need to consider, and what all terms you need to find. That will be my absolute humidity, molar humidity, percentage humidity, relative humidity, dew point, humid volume, humid heat, and enthalpy. These are the parameters you need to find, and we got the two known parameters, that is my dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. So this is how a psychrometric chart looks for air water system having a pressure of 1 atmosphere. And when you change the pressure, the chart will also vary. Now we are considering only 1 atmosphere pressure. So here we know a dry bulb temperature of 50 degrees and a wet bulb temperature of 32.4. So what I will do, first I will plot this wet bulb temperature. That means at 34 degrees, see this is 30 and this is 40, and there are only 5 points here. That means 30, 32.5, 35, 37.5, and 40. Now here it is given 32.4. I will be taking 32.4 on the x-axis and I will be moving towards the 100% humidity. So this will be my point on 100% humidity. Now these are the adiabatic saturation curve. As I told you, these points are the adiabatic saturation curves. Now I will be following this adiabatic saturation curve, and my dry bulb temperature is given as 50 degrees centigrade. That is, this is my dry bulb temperature. From here, I will draw a vertical line. Now, after drawing this vertical line, you got a point here, point of intersection of this adiabatic saturation curve and the dry bulb temperature. So this point, you will get the absolute humidity. This will be my absolute humidity. From the curve, you can find this absolute humidity has 0.024, because this is 0.02 and this is 0.03. This is 0.025. So it is just below it. I am taking it as 0.024. This is my absolute humidity. This is how you need to find the parameters using the two known quantities. Now from the graph, you got the absolute humidity as 0.024 kg of water per kg of dry air. And the second point, it was asked to find the molar humidity. So as I defined, the absolute humidity is equal to molar humidity into 18/29. So which will be y is equal to, molar humidity is equal to y dash into 29/18. And my absolute humidity is 0.024 into 29/18. Which is equal to 0.3866 kilomole of water per kilomole of dry air. This is my molar humidity. You need to be very clear with the units also when you are defining any term. Now I got the two parameters from the question, that is my absolute humidity and molar humidity. Now moving to the psychrometric chart again, we need to find the percentage humidity. Here the percentage humidity is given varying from 2, 5, 10, 20 to 100%, and this is our point of intersection. That means it lies between these two curves, which are 20 and 30. So in between our percentage humidity curve lies, and taking this curve parallel to the 30%, I can draw one more curve here. Now from this you can observe that my percentage humidity will be 28%. So this is how you need to find the percentage humidity. From the graph, what I got my percentage humidity as 28%. Or else you can find with an alternative method, where from the Antoine equation we know that the vapor pressure log is equal to 11.96481 minus 3984.923 divided by T minus 39.724. So this is you will finding from the graphical method, and from these you will be finding with analytical method. So I got this Antoine equation. My dry bulb temperature is given as 50°C. So converting into Kelvin, it will be 323 Kelvin. Now here this pressure will be in bar and the temperature will be in Kelvin. That's why units are important when you are substituting in any equation. Now from substituting here, my log of vapor pressure will be equal to 11.96481 minus 3984.923 by 323 minus 39.724. It will give you a vapor pressure value of 0.12215 bar. Now you know the percentage humidity. I have defined it as the absolute humidity by the absolute humidity at saturation into 100. Now you know the absolute humidity is equal to the molar humidity, that is my PA by P minus PA into 18 by 29. So at saturation it will be y dash of s is equal to vapor pressure. This partial pressure will be equal to vapor pressure at saturation, right? So you can write it in terms of vapor pressure. And the vapor pressure term, you know that is equal to 0.12215 by the pressure is equal to 1.013 minus 0.12215 into 18 divided by 25. So my saturation absolute humidity will be equal to 0.0851. Now we got this absolute humidity as 0.024 and the saturation absolute humidity we got here 0.0851 into 100, which will be equal to 28.19%. This is my percentage humidity that I got from analytical method, and from the graphical method my percentage humidity is 28%, which is almost matching. So you can find in any way, if you use a psychrometric chart, it is in a one picture you can get the all terms, and from the analytical method it takes a time where from the definition you need to proceed with the known quantities. I got my percentage humidity. Now coming to the relative humidity. What is my relative humidity? Partial pressure by vapor pressure into 100, right? I need to find the partial pressure now. How can I find the molar humidity? I know it, which is equal to PA by P minus PA. That means I know the molar humidity, I know the pressure. I need to find the partial pressure now. So just modifying this equation, y into P minus y into PA is equal to PA. Then from this my PA, the partial pressure will be equal to P by 1 plus y into y. Substituting the known terms here, the pressure is equal to 1.013 by 1 plus 0.03866 into 0.03866, which will be equal to 0.0377. This will be my partial pressure. And you know the vapor pressure that we got from the Antoine equation. Substituting here, that is 0.0377 divided by the vapor pressure will be equal to 0.12215 into 100, which will be equal to 30.86%. So this is my relative humidity, that is 30.86, and my percentage humidity is 29.19. Now moving to the psychrometric chart again, we need to find the dew point from this curve. Now as I told you, I have my absolute humidity here, and extending this line till the 100% humidity will give my dew point temperature, that is my saturated air. Now after moving this horizontally towards 100 degrees, you take a vertical line towards the temperature x-axis, which will give me my dew point temperature, that is this point, which is equal to 27.5 degrees. This will be my dew point temperature. Till now we got the 5 terms, and next again coming to humid volume. To find the humid volume, I have told you there are 2 humid volumes, that is a specific volume dry air and saturated humid volume. So you need to find these 2 quantities initially from the graph, later from this you can extrapolate to find the humid volume. Now this dry bulb temperature I am taking a vertical line where at two points, that at first point, that is my specific volume of dry air here, it is coinciding, and from here I got this value as 0.91. This is my humid volume. So this is a 0.9 and this is 1, which means that this will be my 0.95 in between. So it is near to the 0.9, that will be equal to 0.91. And again, if I take at the point of intersection of this saturated humid volume and dry bulb temperature, at this point I will get my humid volume from here as 1.045. As you know, this point is 1.05, so it is just below it. I am taking it approximately 1.045. Now you got the two points, that is the specific volume dry air and saturated humid volume, and by interpolating these two points you will get the humid volume. Now Y dash and VH. The humid volume, I told you 0.91 for dry air. Dry air means my absolute humidity will be zero, that is no moisture content. And at saturated humid volume, my humid volume I got as 0.045. 1.045, and the saturated absolute humidity, that I know as 0.0851. Then I need to find the humid volume at 0.024. This point, let me take it as X. This I need to find out from these known quantities Y dash and VH. So by interpolating it, that means I will take 0.0851 minus 0 by 0.0851 minus 0.024 is equal to 1.045 minus, for 0 my humid volume is 0.91, so 0.91 divided by 0.0851, it will be 1.045 minus for 0.024, my humid volume I have taken as X. So this is how an interpolation works. From this equation, if you find the value of X, that will be my humid volume, which is equal to 0.948 meter cube per kg of dry air. This will be my humid volume. And I think you know the interpolation method. If you don't know, I will just tell you. Suppose if you have 1, 2, 3 known quantities, and at for one value you have some 0.1, and for two value you need to find, and for three value suppose you have some 0.3 equation. So as you don't know the equation, suppose if you know the equation in terms of y is equal to function of x, you can find it. But here you don't know anything, only you know the three points, and in these three points for two values you know the value of y, that is 0.1 and 0.3, and you need to find the value for x equal to 2. So you don't have an equation, but from these three values you can know that it lies in between 0.1 to 0.3 interpolation. So to find this value, you just take 3 minus 1 by 3 minus 2, and for 3 that is 0.3, and for 1 it will be the 0.1, and again for 3 it is 0.3, and I need to find x, that is at 0.2. From here you can find the value of x. This is how an interpolation technique works. I am taking it as linear, my function is varying linear, and in this way you can find out. Now you got the humid volume from the graphical method. And analytical method, I have told you The humid volume is equal to 1 by 29 plus y dash, that is equal to 0.024 divided by 18 into 1.013 into 10 power 5 by the total pressure. Here 1.013 into 10 power 5 is my total pressure into my dry bulb temperature plus 273 by 273, and here the dry bulb temperature is 50 degrees into the volume, specific volume 22.4. So this is how I have defined, and substituting the values of the absolute humidity and the dry bulb temperature, you can find the humid volume as 0.949 meter cube per kg of dry air. So in this analytical method also you can find the humid volume, which is almost near to our value that we got graphically, that is 948. And coming to the humid heat, which I have defined humid heat as 1.005 plus 1.88 into y dash, absolute humidity. Now substituting the absolute humidity that we know, which is 0.024, so my humid heat will be 1.05 kilojoule per kg of dry air into Kelvin. This is my humid heat. Now the last term that we need to find is the enthalpy. Again going to this graph, similarly what technique we have applied to the humid volume, the same applies to the enthalpy also. As you can see, there are two curves, that is enthalpy of saturated air and enthalpy of dry air. These are the two curves. Now for the dry bulb temperature, if I take a vertical line at 50 degrees, you can see the point of intersection for the enthalpy is here, and the point of intersection for the enthalpy of saturated air is this point. So just taking these values from the y-axis, that is the enthalpy is given here ranging from 0 to 280. Now the point here is the enthalpy of dry air, which is equal to 50. And from here the enthalpy of saturated air is equal to 275. Now after getting these two values, by interpolation we can get the enthalpy of this air at particular humidity. Enthalpy, now taking the absolute humidity and enthalpy that we got from the curve, for dry air, that is my absolute humidity is 0, enthalpy I got it as 50, and I need to find the absolute humidity of 0.024 quantity of enthalpy, and the saturated absolute humidity is 0.0851. For this I got 275 as enthalpy from the psychometric chart, and I need to find this value. Let me take it as y. So the same method applies to the humid volume and enthalpy, and from the interpolation, that is 0.0851 minus 0 by 0.0851 minus 0.024 is equal to, for 0.0851 my enthalpy is 275, and for 0 it is 50 divided by 275, and for this absolute humidity I need to find the value of enthalpy, that is equal to y. From this you will get the value of y as 112.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. So this will be my enthalpy at this absolute humidity. Now analytically, I can find enthalpy. That I have defined the enthalpy as humid heat into Td minus T reference temperature plus y dash into lambda. This is my enthalpy. Now the humid heat that I got is equal to 1.05, and let me take my reference temperature as 0 degree centigrade. So the dry bulb temperature is given as 50 minus the reference temperature is 0 plus my absolute humidity is equal to 0.024 into the value of lambda, that is latent heat of vaporization for water, is 2500. From here I can find the enthalpy as 112.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Now again, the values that we got analytically and the value that we got from the curve are matching. So this is how you need to find the different parameters by knowing any two parameters. So if I give you in brief, from the question it is given dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature, two quantities, and from these two quantities the first value I got is my absolute humidity and I got my percentage humidity. Later I have found the dew point temperature, then the specific volume and my enthalpy. So from the two quantities of dry bulb and wet bulb temperature, I got the other five quantities and some more terms like relative humidity, molar humidity and humid heat. These all things I found using the equations that we know. This is how a psychrometric chart is useful. Suppose if I take a sling thermometer, from there I will get the dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature. And after getting these two temperatures from the psychrometric chart, I can find the all other parameters. And the psychrometric chart is very important tool when we take in the design of water cooling towers or in the design of air conditioners. I think it is clear from this lecture how to find the different parameters using a psychrometric chart. Thank you. If you like my video, subscribe to my channel to get more updates from my channel.